Welcome back to Let's Play The Outer Worlds, Blind. Talk to Phineas Wells.
Welcome back, Captain. Now that you have acquired a nav key to Stellar Bay, would you like me to contact Dr. Wells?
Doesn't this guy have a life?
I don't believe so, Captain. Transmission incoming.
Okay.
Well done. You'll love Monarch. Exotic climate, violent native species, fascinating culture, really.
Oh, yeah.
You'll need to speak with Hiram Blythe. He's known as the information broker, and for good reason. If anyone knows where I can find those chemicals, it's Hiram. I need those chemicals to revive the Hope's colonists. They can help us fight back against the Board. They can help us set things right. If we don't put a stop to the Board, they're going to drive this colony toward a complete societal collapse. You'll see what I mean when you arrive on Monarch.
Alright, so we need to meet a shadow broker. I mean, information broker. You sound like you've been to Monarch.
No, never. Monarch is a hotbed of political activity. I can't imagine why Hiram set up shop there. Cuisine, perhaps?
A hotbed of political activity. Sounds like fun.
I certainly wouldn't call it boring, especially if your idea of fun involves navigating a hostile biosphere populated by carnivorous monsters. You'll want to hire the services of a skilled guide. I recommend a hunter by the name of Nyoka. Frequents the drinking establishments of Stellar Bay. Very hard to miss.
Nyoka.
Once you have everything you need, make your way to Hiram Blythe's compound.
Well, I've got some questions for you.
Come see me in my lab. I'll answer any questions you have.
Really? You can just answer them now? Fine, I'm off.
Best of luck. Everyone on the Hope is counting on you.
Let's go all the way to your lab just to ask you more questions, of which there probably won't be any new ones. Monarch! So we've also got... Oh, we can't travel there. And we can't travel there. Can't travel there. Scylla we can travel to. Terra 2, Phineas' lab, yeah. The only place we can travel to is Monarch. Okay, the warning dangerous Cascadia landing pad or the Stellar Bay landing pad. How about we'll go for the Stellar Bay landing pad?
We're now in orbit above Stellar Bay, Captain. Welcome back, Captain. How can I be of assistance? I request you do not wake me if I am sleeping upon your return.
You don't sleep, though. I thought there was something moving, like a quest thing. Wanna join me on Stellar Bay?
Something busted, Captain?
I suppose anyone has anything new to say. They didn't last time. And it's only been like a half hour since then, so... Do I want to improve my weapons and stuff? Oh. That's Sam. I think I tinkered this. Did I? Oh no, it just costs a lot of money. I like this assault rifle. Yeah, I'll tinker this a little bit. Can't tinker it anymore. That's a lot of money. I'll do it. Ouch. Well, that's gonna be almost all my money. Alright. Now, these are worn by various crew members, so I can tinker their stuff, but I want to tinkle my own. Oh, Ellie? Ellie can level up. Oh, when I go here, I can get access to everybody. Cool. Boisterous. Oh, I did that? Decrease? Alright. Let's give her more health. That's cool. I didn't realize I could just be in the ship and deal with everybody. I'm like, I have to take them with me in order to give him... That's what I did with Felix last time. I had to take him... Well, I thought I had to take him with me. So the Elite Troop Armor, 43, and the Full Cranial Helmet, 43. I'm guessing it would be mine. The first two things. Oh, now they don't all show up. See that? Right. Oh, wait, because I'm in Modify, that's why. So that's my armor. It's getting expensive. 49 armor. So this helmet's mine, really? Full cranial? Yeah, alright. Yep, I can't even increase it anymore. Kind of want to hold on to the rest of my money, too. I get more money, I'll come back and improve my friends as well. Improve their armor and weapons, rather, not my friends themselves. They're already perfect just the way they are. Wait. Oh, I have to deselect first. Bring Parvati and Sam. Monarch. This place looks like a mess already. Nyoka is 58 meters away.
Muting volume now.
Muting volume. Can't jump on those. All right. Sweet. I don't see anybody around, do you? What do we got on here? Argo's traffic system status operational. Insert captains. Oh yeah, it's supposed to come back. Well, we don't want to just jump down there. That's a spacer's choice thingy. Alright, guys, ready?
Hey, hold on there. I gotta sign you in.
You sign me in?
Don't think I've seen you around. That means it must be new to Stellar Bay. You are new here, right?
You seem surprised.
You must have seen those UDL gunships on your way in. There's only three of them these days. Still, they tend to scare folk off.
I didn't notice. Oh, up on the landing pad? I'm not sure if I noticed gunships. What are they doing out here?
You may not have heard, you being new, but Stellar Bay hardly ever gets off-road traffic. Us being cut off by the board and all. Which means I never get to do this part, but I've been practicing, so here goes.
Oh boy.
On behalf of Monarch Stellar Industries, welcome to Stellar Bay, home of the freshest sal tuna in Halcyon. Please state your name for the records.
I prefer to travel discreetly, if you know what I mean.
Aw, don't be like that. I never get to do this part. Please.
Fine, I'm Captain Alicia Clark.
Swell. There's one for the logs. I'm even gonna give you your own entry code.
Sweet.
I'm not supposed to do that. It's against procedure, but Mr. Sanjar isn't so strict about the rules here. Besides, I got a lot of empty entries to fill.
So just by telling him our name, our reputation increased. I guess it's worth that. Is Stellar Bay really that isolated?
We don't get ship traffic in town. Only off-worlders who do make it out here are sublight. They got a base in Fallbrook.
Hmm.
And thank the stars for them, or we would have run out of Rizzo's Purple Berry Crunch years ago.
You're not what I expected to find on Monarch.
Oh, that'll just make Mr. Sanjar's day if you tell him. The board makes up lots of nasty stories about raptodons and cannibals and whatnot. But that's all outside our walls. Mostly.
Are you saying the board's been lying about this place? No kidding.
Oh, sure. They make Stellar Bay sound like a rotten place, but it's not so bad. Get a good breeze going, and the sulfur smell mostly covers up the fishy smell. Anyway, Mr. Sanjar's got lots to say on that subject. Kinda goes over my head, though.
Alright, gonna have a look around town.
Mr. Sanjar will be mighty pleased to meet you. If you see him over at headquarters, maybe you could tell him I did a bang-up job of welcoming you?
Maybe.
Oh, and if you're headed that way, maybe you could do me a favor?
Well, that depends. What is it?
I got this Rizzo's Rangers tossball poster coming in on the next sublight shipment, signed by the Black Hole himself. Only I haven't heard anything in a while. You think you could check with Celia to see if it's come in?
Who's the Black Hole?
That's Bertie Holcomb. Only one of the greatest tossball hackers ever.
I wonder if he's kin. Dad had family that worked for Rizzo's. I never got to meet them.
Everyone's heard of him. Even on Monarch. We still get some
name.
Of the games. You've been living in a sulfur pit or something?
I know Holcomb sounded familiar when they call her Miss Holcomb. But why is he called the Black Hole?
On account of him being the best hacker who ever played, nothing gets by him. He sucks up every ball that comes his way.
Maybe word that differently.
Well, Holcomb's had a lot of nicknames over his career. Used to be the tallywhacker on account of what he'd do to the score. Before that, he was a slick stick, because his shots were always so smooth.
Let's not talk about this ever again.
Whatever you say. I could talk tossball for hours.
That poster sounds pretty valuable.
I couldn't really say. I'm just a fan of the game.
Hmm.
But the fancy collector types say the more people see these things, the less valuable they are. And I figure my poster's been passed around by more than a few people by now.
Alright, well, I'm sure I can ask about your poster.
Thanks a bunch. Celia works for Mr. Sanjar in the MSI building next to the bar. She's always there, so you can't miss her.
Okay. Grim is waiting for a tossball poster signed by the great Bertie Black Hole Holcomb. Celia, who works for Sanjar Nandi in the MSI building, should know about the status of Grimm's poster. So apparently there's no science weapon here. Hephaestus mining. Unless the Hephaestus mining thing says about something about it. Oh, the Hephaestus mining leads to Scylla, never mind. Alright. The information broker, Shadow Broker, promised to find a location of the chemicals needed by Phineas. Problem is, he hasn't delivered the intel on time and hasn't provided an explanation. Travel to Monarch, find him, and obtain the data. Phineas contacted the broker through a well-known Monarch big game hunter named Nyoka. She frequents the yacht club in Stellar Bay, so look for her there. Alright. We are going to be looking around at everything I can, anyway. Not stealing things where people can see. Anyway. What's all this out in the middle of nowhere? Really, nobody around? So we can't go in there. Okay, never mind. I immediately look at these yellow things and think of mine. We got some vending machines. We can sell the stuff we just stole. That's it.
Wouldn't mind smelling like salt tuna if we could sell more of it.
So good about salt tuna. I know can take that stuff.
Watch your step if you venture outside the walls.
Thanks.
We're not the best equipped, but scouting for rapids keeps us on our toes.
You got one of those Reaper things. Pretty cool looking. Oh, there's the yacht club.
What are the chances of all the times and places we could have been born?
Yeah.
We're here, light years from Earth, going about our lives.
Every time the punch clock peals, a worker earns his meals.
What are you talking about?
Sorry, I thought you were quoting It's a Wonderful Directorate.
Hi.
You don't look like Sublight. Must be freelance.
Kinda.
You don't look like Sublight. Must be freelance.
That's been a talk about town. For the last 10 seconds. Greetings, Bennett.
Laws. Can't a man enjoy the smooth menthol flavor of a Stogie Slim in peace?
You're not allowed a brass for a man doing absolutely nothing.
What I am doing, ma'am, is enjoying the moment. It's so rare that I can seize one apart from the jabbering masses of this wretched place.
What are you talking about?
This law's forgotten town. Cut off from the rest of the colony. Removed from any culture. I recall when Stellar Bay was a proper board-affiliated town with regular shipments of Anti-Cleo's best and all the cereals. Before Sanjar took over MSI and got us all booted.
You missed the good old days?
Days of consumption and culture. When we weren't squabbling with the iconoclasts for lack of better things to do. Look, you're making me melancholy. Is there something you wanted?
Well, I guess not. I'll leave you be.
We don't get many outsiders.
Yeah, I gathered.
Got my sights on you.
I guess then you got eyes in the back of your head. Alright, let's go in to... Was it the Yacht Club? Is this where we're going to find what's her name? What the... Yeah. Nyoka. Well, I guess that's her. Hello there.
And the little bastard's slippery, right? On account of its blood, so it's sliding. All over the place, trying to crawl away.
Yeah, excuse me?
Getting so I can't tell the blood from the mud.
Actually, I'll keep listening.
But I gotta get in there. Get right in that baby rat's stomach and dig it out. If so much as a drop of stomach acid got on that medallion, I'd... Shit, I don't know what I'd do. Might be I'd hunt every damn wrapped out there. Right. What are you staring? Wait. You ain't from around here. Who are you?
Militia Clark. Pleasure to meet you.
Ooh, charmer. Don't get a lot of that around here. Folks mostly grump at me about how I should join the MSI payroll. Nice change of pace. Buy me a drink, will you?
Sure. Another round, bartender.
Outstand! What are you doing in Stellar Bay, stranger?
I'm told you can help me find an information broker.
Well. Let's get down to brass nuts then, shall we? Wait, that ain't it. Brass rats? Let's talk business. I'm headed back out there after I sober up. You want a guide sooner than that? You'll have to get me something to clear my head.
Sure, what do you need?
Outstanding! Our dispensary here maintains a stock of, I don't rightly know what they are. Steroid or caffeine somethings? Pills. They're very good. I'm cut off for the month, on account of needing one just about every damn day. But I'm sure you've got your wily ways. Fetch me one and we'll be all set.
You mean caffeinoid? That stuff's just a stimulant.
Well, they work. We got a deal or what?
You won't find a better deal in Halcyon. Then our special one-time offer for a refurbished sanitation unit.
Yeah, you should
have
said
that. Remember, if it's dirty, it's a job for Sam.
What in the... That thing talks?
Yeah, that's, Sam. He, she? It helps me stay clean. Anyway, I'll go get those meds. Sweet. Alright. We need to level up. Skills and perks. What a persuade's only a 50. I couldn't persuade someone with something. Oh, that's right. Now, should I just get everything? Kind of tempted to just get everything to 50 and then go from there. Yeah. That'll do for now, I guess. No, apply. And I could take another perk. Movement penalty. Move faster during tactical time dilation. Yeah, see, I'm always having companions in my party, so I'm not gonna choose one of those. Thing is, I don't use a tactical time dilation much. I mean, I guess I could start using it more. Science weapon thing, I guess I can start using the gun more. Shrink ray. Or deal increased weak spot damage. Let me take this. Alright. Do you have anything else to say?
The Charmer! Welcome back. Drink, chat, or business? All of the above?
Never mind. Alright, so... Nyoka said she'll guide you through the Monarch Wilderness, but only if you can sober her up. So then it'll be like four of us. That'd be sweet. Nyoka needs a steroid or caffeine something that dispensary serves them, but she has reached her month's allotment. So it's caffeine, whatever I said, whatever I told her. I'll remember when I see him. You'll have to cure her of her hangover first. Requires completion of the quest Passion Pills, yeah. MSI building. Alright. I'll sober her up when I'm ready. How about that? Vendor.
Not a peep for me.
Don't run around like that. Nyoka Bar Talk Bingo Sheet. Several phrases have been marked off right between the eyes. There were three, no, four of them. That rat was this big. Took it down with one shot. Buy me a drink. Close? Oh, the... We just leave these mag picks laying around.
Well, we don't get many outsiders. Watch your step if you venture outside the walls.
Thanks.
Watch your step if you venture outside the walls.
Been hearing that.
Got any news from the rest of Halcyon?
Not much.
Well, well. It isn't often we see new folk in Stellar Bay. First drink's on me, stranger.
And a mustache. Okay, thanks.
Enjoy. If you plan on sitting through Nyoka's stories, you might could use a few.
I could use a few in telling them myself.
Now what can I do for you?
How well do you know Nyoka?
Anyone who spends any amount of time in this bar is bound to get to know Nyoka. On account of her being here so often herself. And I don't mean that unkindly.
Okay.
Anyone who's rid us of as many beasts as you have is entitled to a few drinks. Something else I can do for you?
More than a few, I'm guessing. You said you're not used to seeing new faces around here.
Not since Amber Heights. These days we have more leaving than coming. Off to join the Iconoclasts or some such.
What happened at Amber Heights?
Bunch of marauders broke into the executive compound, slaughtered everyone.
Oh, damn.
Corporations pulled out of Monarch not long after. I thought everyone knew. But then that was 10 years ago. Still feels fresh to us every time we look at our walls, though.
It's not like you have just some place where I can read the history of all these colonies. That would be great to actually get a hold of, but doesn't seem to exist. Why is this place called the Yacht Club?
Thought it had a fancy ring to it. Name's the first advertising anyone sees, after all.
Are there any yachts in Stellar Bay? I'm thinking not.
Nope. But a man can dream.
What's that other question?
Thought it had a fancy ring to it. Name's the first advertising anyone sees, after all.
You might think about fixing up that sad-looking sign outside.
Don't be so negative. It's what's on the inside that counts. Speaking of, you look like you could use a bottle with something good in it.
Yeah, nothing right now, thanks. I'm gonna take a peek upstairs. Hi.
We don't get many outsiders.
You sure don't.
Watch your step if you venture outside the walls.
Thanks. Oh. Nice little balcony. Caleb?
New face, huh? You from off-world?
Yep. Captain Alicia Clark of the Unreliable.
A ship captain? Well, I'll be. Here, let me buy you a drink.
Huh.
Consider it an MSI welcome.
These people are pretty nice.
Why don't you grab a chair, sit a spell, and revel with us?
By the smell, he's been reveling enough for you both already.
You're not kidding, Parvati. Well, these people are pretty nice. I already got 2 free drinks. What are you celebrating?
Me and my friends have taken our destiny into our own hands. We're untethered, free of responsibility and worldly cares. Well, as long as we don't run out of bits. But until the windfall's gone, we're riding high. See, we just walked out on our work. Had enough, we did. So now we're striking.
Won't you get in trouble for that?
I don't see how. When Sanjar took over MSI, he tossed all the old corporate rules. We ain't required no more to work whatever job the company demands. Our supervisor, Velma, goes on and on about quarterly profits and meeting quotas. But that ain't what Sanjar promised us. Velma refuses to negotiate, so we're refusing to work. We won't go back until she agrees to pay us fair and proper. Us on Monarch, we're free from the board, you know? We have the right to lobby for better hours and pay.
Hmm. Well, I happen to be reasonably good with negotiations.
I wouldn't doubt it. You look like the type who tends to come out on top. Not like us cogs, trying to be the squeaky wheel but just getting deadlocked. It's been days, but Velma won't even hear us out. Maybe you could just make her listen to our demands.
Sure, I'll mediate with her on your behalf.
You would do that? We sure are lucky you decided to come up to the patio today. I knew drinking up here would be good for more than the view.
We need to talk about Velma.
Sure thing. What did you want to discuss?
Any suggestions for how to put pressure on Velma to negotiate?
If I knew that, I'd have tried it. Talking reasonably got me nowhere. Maybe you'll fare better.
Hmm.
The others wanted to blackmail her. But we're above that. Besides, them are just rumors. We got no proof they're true.
What's this about blackmail?
I would never endorse such an untoward tactic, you know, but, well, there's rumors that Velma's taking a cut off the profits. So far, it's just gossip, you know, but if there was any proof to be had, it'd be in the Saltuna warehouse, I reckon.
Hmm.
Sure thing. What did you want to discuss?
How long can you afford to miss work?
Not forever, but we've each saved up our bits, and I stashed them safe in my home by the diner. I reckon we could last a week or two, at least.
All right. I'll talk to you later. New quest. Caleb and the autoloader... Oh, these are what these guys are? Autoloader operators are asking for a raise, but their boss, Velma Ballard, refuses to negotiate. Velma Ballard manages the warehouse in Stellar Bay. Caleb's living off a stash of bits he keeps at home near the diner. If this stash were to go missing, he'd have to return to work. Caleb believes Velma has been skimming money out of the warehouse accounts. If If you can find proof, you can use that as leverage to make Velma negotiate. Alright. Well, I can help with that. Finding proof and all, or just negotiate without it. Or, alternatively, maybe I can steal the stash of bits for myself, and then he'd have to return to work. That'd be the evil option.
It'll be good to get some steady pay again.
Thanks for the help. Still, this is a nice break from the warehouse.
Alright, well, what's in here? Ah.
I wonder sometimes what they're doing on other colonies.
Uh-huh.
Think they're watching the same serials, following the same tossball games?
Mm-hmm.
You're not listening to a word, are you?
Look, my back aches and everything smells like fish. I just want to enjoy my beer.
Well, these guys have the most fruitful conversations. I picked up a pistol. The spacious choice, yeah. Okay. How big is this place? I guess we'll finish exploring at least.
Got any news from the rest of Halcyon?
Yeah. The world is ending, or worlds are ending. So you really can't sneak with him around? I'm not sure. Pretty nice, he doesn't sneak. Oh yeah, I didn't think so. What is this? Is this the MSI building? There's important looking sentries outside.
Got any news from the rest of Halcyon?
Guys are all looking for news. Let's see what's in here first. Monarch Stellar. Oh, is this MSI? Is that what? Monarch Stellar Inc.?
You're probably looking for Velma. Watch out. She's in a mood.
Oh, I guess we're gonna look for Velma. What's back here, though? Vending machine. I've seen that sign before. Mining helmet. That's it. Oh no, we got this as well. I think I'm just gonna break this stuff down. They're telling me about Codex. Oh, the log, yeah. I don't know where we can see. Like how many, what do you call it? Armor parts and stuff that we have. Oh, I got a piecemeal mining helmet. Bathroom. Okay, this is a big facility. Well, there's Velma. Hi.
Look, you can tell Catherine the new shipment will be ready when it's ready, all right? She's welcome to come up here and pack boxes herself if she's in such a hurry.